Hi friends, in this video we will see transport and peripheral conversion of thyroid hormones. So let's start. These are various organs of our body. And this is circulating blood, kind of road connecting all the organs. Now as we have seen in video of thyroid hormone synthesis, T4 accounts for most of the hormones released from thyroid gland. To be more specific, it's about 90% of total hormones released. About 10% is T3. And RT3 is very little and it's inactive anyway, so let's ignore it. In blood, we have various plasma proteins secreted from liver. Most of the hormones bind with these plasma proteins and very little is in free form. T4 binds more avidly as compared to T3. About 99.98% of T4 is bound with plasma proteins. Binding of T3 is slightly less. It's 99.8% protein bound and 0.2% is in free form. This free form acts on various tissues. Protein-bound hormone is not available for action or metabolism. Among plasma proteins, thyroid-binding globulin is major one. 70% of circulating thyroid hormones bind with thyroid-binding globulin, about 20% with albumin, and about 10% with transthyretin. This plasma protein binding serves two main purposes. First, it acts as readily available reserve of thyroid hormones in blood and prevents acute fluctuations in free thyroid level. And second, it prevents metabolism of these hormones and prolongs their half-life. This is clearly reflected in half-life of these two hormones. T4 is more avidly bound, so its half-life is longer than T3. It's about 8 days. And half-life of T3 is 1 day. Many diseases like liver cirrhosis affects level of these proteins. Change in level of these proteins usually don't affect function of thyroid hormones as level of free hormone is not affected. So this was about protein binding. Now let's talk about thyroid hormone activity. Although T3 is secreted in smaller quantity, it accounts for most of the thyroid hormone activity. That is because it is 10 times more potent than T4. T4 serves as prohormone for T3. It is converted to T3 by deiodination at various tissues. There are three different types of deiodinase enzyme for this: D1, D2, and D3. Liver and kidney are main sites of deiodination and they have D1. It removes one iodine from outer ring and thus converts T4 into T3. This peripheral deiodination also produces RT3. But it's inactive, so let's ignore it again. This T3 is then released into the circulation and utilized by various tissues. Brain and pituitary are exception. They don't take T3 from blood. They rather take T4 and convert it into T3 in-house by its own D2. D3 is found in placenta. It removes iodine from inner ring and produces RT3. Thus, T3 is largely produced at peripheral sites as compared to its direct synthesis at thyroid gland. Eventually, the thyroid hormones are metabolized by further deiodination to form deiodinated thyronine. Some of T3 and T4 undergo glucuronide or sulfate conjugation and secreted in intestine. Some of it is hydrolyzed in intestine and undergo enterohepatic circulation before final excretion. So that was about peripheral conversion and final metabolism. Now let's have quick revision. In thyroid release, 90% is T4 and 10% is T3. RT3 is negligible. T4 is 99.98% plasma protein bound and T3 is 99.8% protein bound. Thyroid binding globulin accounts for 70% of binding of thyroid hormones, albumin for 20%, and transthyretin for 10%. Protein-bound hormones serves as reserve and prevents acute fluctuations in free thyroid level. It also prevents metabolism and prolongs half-life of hormones in blood. Half-life of T4 is about 8 days and that of T3 is about 1 day. T3 is more potent than T4 and is responsible for most of the thyroid actions. T4 serves as prohormone for T3. It is converted to T3 by three types of deiodinase enzymes. D1 is present in liver and kidney. It produces T3, which is utilized by various tissues. Brain and pituitary takes T4 and converts it into T3 locally by D2. Placenta has D3 which produces RT3. Eventually, hormone undergo final metabolism by further deiodination to form thyronine. Some of the hormones undergo conjugation and excreted by hepatic route. That's it for transport and peripheral conversion of thyroid hormones. Did you find this video helpful? If yes, share it with your friends. And if no, drop your comments in comment section. And don't forget to subscribe because lots more to come. See you in next video. Thank you.